Hello, hello, hello. So I just had a really sweet session. They had some really great information coming forward about, all the things that we've been thinking about, wishing, wanting, working towards, and had some sweet messages coming in from Sophia, from the Cosmic Mother, and just some other kind of behind the scenes things that might make sense to some of you and may help some of you just with where you are in your path. So you can see with the title of this, I put it really strongly, Divine Justice Shall Be Served. Because the themes that have been coming up for me personally, and what I'm also seeing in my clients, is that has been this challenge, this fear, this struggle to really use our voice, to really stand in our full power, to stand as divine beings and let people know what is coming. And there's been these common fears of like people not understanding, people ridiculing, people being called crazy, even like some stuff from people's past where maybe have been hospitalized or kicked out of, families or communities simply for speaking about their experience. And a lot of us have a lot of fear still stored within our soul and maybe even in our bodies at those times where they burned people like us, where we were burned, or had our heads chopped off or were drowned or whatever they did to keep the truth from surfacing. And now the tables have turned and justice is on its way. And we are getting our voices and we're getting our strength and we have found each other. And nothing is going to stop this momentum of love and light and truth that is going to blast through this planet, through each and every one of us individually, and also through us as a collective. Through the mouths of babies, the truth shall come through. And I've just been hanging out with some kids this last week as I started the Little Masters program. 12 little disciples came to play. Ooh, man, it's our future looking bright. These children are incredibly powerful, really clear. And we have to do everything in our power to keep them in a place of safety and to keep them deprogrammed. So I see mothers walking out on the streets with their signs, holding their signs very lovingly, but very strongly saying, enough, these are our children. You cannot mess with our children any longer. We won't stand up for it. And so I really just applaud all of you who are standing in your power. I also applaud those of you who are still standing with a little bit of resistance, just waiting, just having that, being pulled back, being pulled back, being pulled back, because soon you're going to launch forward and you're going to shine so much love out into this world. It's going to change everything around you. And I'm super, super excited to be with you on the planet while all this happens. So I'm sending you all so much love. Okay, this is enough. We have been bullied enough. I'm even going through something here in my own like reality where I'm dealing with some people who have money, who have power. They think they have power, but they're out of alignment. And so Ron and I are getting some really sweet opportunities to find our power, to source our power, and to speak up because our experience is valid. Your experience is valid, and it's time for you to stand up and share. And if you need, gather a friend to stand next to you and hold space for you while you share your truth and your experience, because it is so needed. You carry the keys to a new world within your own voice. So just let your voice be heard. Find your song and sing it to anyone that can hear. So anyway, that's my little bit of passion that's coming through about, or my inspiration. So what came through from Divine Mother is that she just so loves her children. She loves her children so much, and she wants us to know that things will be back to the way things were. Restoration is coming. The blueprint was interfered with, the original plan was distorted, and we must trust and relax into that trust, knowing that everything that we are holding in our hearts is coming. What they were sharing was that her inner world, the client that I was working with today, her inner world will soon be an outer world. And how they were explaining this is really interesting. And my hair is standing up, so there's lots of beings with me right now as I share this message. But they were saying the blue and the white sun must come together. And they explained the blue sun, and if anyone has information about this stuff or has seen things that support this in any way, just kind of make sure you make some comments there. But they were saying that the blue sun and the white sun, when they come together, what it does is that the frequency shifts. So the blue sun is the fifth dimensional sun, So we may or may not see it, but we can certainly feel what's happening here. So this blue and white sun, once they combine, what it does is the light receptors from our brain begin to change the hormones that are released from the brain, and you begin to see light coming out of that person. We can all see that, oh my gosh, people are getting so gorgeous. Their eyes are shining. Their energy is shining. People are sparkly, and it's really just so cool. You can so easily tell who's on the ascension pathway, who's on the new earth pathway because of the light. And I'm even seeing, you know, the mixture in between. People are still holding on to density, holding on to stories, holding on to this thing. Self-forgiveness was such a big message, a big part of what was coming through today. You hold that key. You hold the density, and no one else can give you permission to let it go except for yourself. So whatever you're struggling with, whatever you're holding on to, it is time. Time to let it go. You've been carrying it long enough. You've been holding it long enough. And a lot of us came in to hold, you know, to take in some density, to transmute it and to clear it. But we really have to do the releasing. We have to clear it. We have to let it go so that we can rise up and be pillars of light, pillars of clarity, of truth, because the density is what is distorting the vision of people. And we're so programmed from the time that we're born to have our vision distorted, to have our perception of our reality, our perception of ourself be so distorted that it was very, very hard to see the truth and to be very clear about what was honest and what wasn't, because the program was so insidious, it was so deep within us that it was hard to really trust ourselves, to trust our experiences, to trust the fact that we're multidimensional. How many people, you know, had psychic experiences, had communication with other beings, light beings, extraterrestrials, inner earth beings, people that passed away, and we had to shut it off because people told us that we were crazy. We were told that, you know, a whole bunch of things. And eventually we just got really confused, and our own intuitive GPS system was derailed. Now, yes, on a greater level, we knew this would happen and we wanted it. That's why we were born and chose to come in. We knew that it would be difficult. And we've done a really, really good job of rising up through that and allowing the light to come out and really dissolve those programs. But there's still a lot of work to do. It's still happening. We've got new people waking up all the time, and they're still in their programs, even though the light is beginning to show for them and to shine through them. They need help with programming. So what that means is, that means sharing the information. That means your voice, that voice that might be hard for you to share, those things that might be hard to share, it is time to get them out. It is time to really share in a big way and to help people see. And often that's all it is. You just have to let them know that there's another way. You just have to let them know that there's another perspective. And as soon as that happens, everything shifts for them. And you'll see fast and rapid change for a lot of people that, you know, for the most part are really, really good people. They're just so programmed to respond to react to information, react to people, react to circumstances in a certain way. Now that brings me back to this point where they were talking about, they were describing once the, so there was the original blueprint, the original perfect design, and then eventually there was, you know, by permission, this was something that was granted through source, was these other beings, these other energies came in. You can call them reptilians, you can call them interlopers. I've heard all, you know, the fallen ones, the fallen Elohim, there's many different names for them, and probably different levels of infiltration. But they're saying that these energies have been removed. And what we're left with mostly here on the planet is our habit of following drama, of following fear. And they said that we don't have to do that anymore. This is a matter of our mastery of our focus, our mastery of our ability to create. So we need to see the drama of the world, but not get so stuck into it. Into it emotionally and get spiraled into that fear thing. If you can stand as a pillar, if you can address the issues that are right here in your community, but come from a loving place, knowing that nothing is going to stop this light from coming through, you have the ability to trust in the fact that this is done. On the spiritual level, this is done. It's taking some time for us to really see it on a physical level, but you can walk out knowing that you have an arm of angelic beings and extraterrestrial beings, inner earth beings, ancestors standing with you as you stand at this pivotal moment in human history. You have so much support. You have nothing to shy away from. You have everything to gain from this, okay? They're so loving this message right now. I'm like tingling so much. So Sophia wanted to share a message today. She said, rising from the ashes, coming home, a pulse is starting, the heartbeat is starting, justice will be served. Fear not, the mother loves her children. All that hurt her children will be sent to the fire. They will burn in the pits. Only the love of the mother will exist. Okay? So as you stand, as you channel your inner Isis, as you channel your inner mother, your inner Mary, your whatever mother, the archetype that you like to work with, as you channel it, know that you have countless mothers standing behind you, waiting and ready to serve through you if you open up to their light and to their wisdom and to their love. Mothers are really sweet, but if you've ever seen... if you've ever seen a small child be in a situation where a mother needs to stand up for her children, you better watch out, because that's like a ferocity that you have. You don't want to be on the other side of that. So what they're also talking about was this huge shift, like this dimensional split, actually, not the shift. There would be really like two worlds, two different things happening at the same time, that by December, they're saying that this is going to be like very, very obvious, that the split is very, very obvious. There are going to be very different realities happening at the same time. So the other thing that I want to go back to is, so this client was being told to her that she needed to heal her she wanted to heal her relationship with Yeshua ben Joseph, with Jesus, but she didn't know what the issue was. So when I asked if Brother Yeshua was around, she had this incredible amount of love pour through her, and she started to cry and cry and cry and cry. And he just wanted to let her know how much he loved her, how much he loves her, how much he would never end in his love for her, and how she's here to do the work. And so I got to ask her, I asked if they would show what she was doing in the lifetime, if she was alive during that time. They said, yes, she was alive. She was one of the women that was walking with him doing the teachings. And so when they went into the session, when we went to that lifetime, the first scene, they were sitting around listening, and she was just like, oh, we're just sitting here and listening to him talk. And we could just listen to him talk forever and ever and ever. And so just so immediately, she went from somebody that was blocked about him to somebody that was just so in love and telling me the message was, all is one, we are one, I am one with all of you. You will not know hunger in your life if you know the Lord, meaning if you know your source, if you know your connection to God, God is all it is, and if you trust in that, if you are devoted to that alignment and know and also receive, so not shaming, keeping yourself down, but opening like a sweet little innocent child reaching to mama, knowing that she's going to give you everything that you want. And so if you know this connection, you will not hunger. And that's not just hunger on the physical level, like I need bread. You will not hunger for love. You will not hunger for support. You will not hunger for grace, because that is the reality that you stand in. As you open to receive that love, and as you allow it to come through you, there is no hunger that could ever last once you're there in that connection, in that light. The next scene that was shown was a very famous scene where Yeshua is going through the temple and tearing apart the tables. She was like, wow, he's like angry. He's like as angry as Jesus can be, but he is pissed. He's not enjoying this. And so for her, this was also a symbol. Where's the message here? Of what's about to happen on this planet is the light of the Christ, this light of Sophia, this light of Creator, whatever you want to call it, comes in, and the light of the Mother comes in. These powers that have been profiting off of our suffering, you know, that have been teaching people that they cannot get to their Savior, they cannot get to their God, they cannot get to whatever without paying money or doing this or doing that. That is something that we all need to know and remind our brethren, our family that's around us, is that we have, as human beings, a direct connection to our Creator. direct connection to angelic support, and it cannot be interfered with. Okay, that's something that you hold, simply closing the eyes, going into the heart, and tending to connect to your creator, connect with your angelic family. You're there, bridge is created. And that's the secret that they've been trying to keep from us. They hijacked the teachings of Yeshua and Mary Magdalene, the disciples, and they turned it into some profiteering thing that's just gross. And you know what? Divine justice is coming. Mama's coming, and things are going to get cleaned up here. So good to be here on the planet during this time. Okay, what else? They were talking about balancing our electromagnetic field. This is talking about the preparation for what's about to come. As we balance our electromagnetic field, we support Gaia's balancing of her electromagnetic field. So this particular client is part of a group that they'd kind of describe as grappling hooks, magnetic grappling hooks that are spread out around the planet in different times. And this may help some of you who feel like, oh, I'm so alone. There's nobody else like me, no one else I can talk to. Everyone has been strategically placed around the planet to anchor in a very specific frequency from where they are, and, you know, a host of other things. Maybe they're able to connect with certain people. Maybe there's an energy that they're holding and protecting. But anyway, this particular type of person has been placed around the world as grappling hooks. So as the electromagnetics change here on the planet, because they are changing and they're about to really change, they act as grappling hooks to anchor in that to anchor in the changes there, so that people that are on that timeline, this is where it gets a little tricky for 3D brains to really hold on to. As they anchor that in, that reality is not going to shift and change a whole lot. It's not going to be so chaotic. It's the people on the other timeline that are not in that energy, that are not in that frequency and on the ascension pathway, that are going to experience a very different reality as these energies come in. So that's the thing. If you are like, oh, am I going to make it to New Earth? Am I like doing enough? The fact that you're even asking that question is already showing you that you're like, you're on the pathway. If anything, just do some more work cleaning your diet, you know, spend some extra time playing in the sun, singing, dancing, connecting with children, playing in the water, whatever you want to do to raise your joy, raise your vibration. That's your ticket there, having as much fun as you possibly can in any given moment and really celebrating life. That's what's going to get you into the new earth, being in the heart, being in your love, forgiving yourself, huge. Okay. So the last thing I'll share about, I think, is that the mantra that they were giving to her is, instead of expecting doom, instead of expecting the gloom that has been shoved down our throats of, you know, fear, 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 I expect benevolence. I expect the event. I expect heaven coming to earth. I am in my knowing that I'm here to serve the light and all that I desire. New earth is coming. The event is coming, and I know it. And I hold it in my heart. Good. Let's see. Oh, 49 comments. Good stuff. Let's see if there's anything I need to comment on. I have a hard time reading these things once I get into it. Okay. I think that's all for me today. It was a really good one. I'm going to go. It's the weekend time. There's like a really fun ecstatic dance thing. I'm going to get myself groovy. I'm going to go dance around in my cosmic, you know, joy for all of you as we celebrate and welcome in the new earth. It's going to be so much fun to dance with you once that day is there. Okay. Sending you so much love. Bye-bye. Oh, maybe I should also say a little bit later, I'm going to put in the comments below. If you want to have a session with me, I'll put in my email address. It's michael@transfermotion.org. If you just email me that, just say you want a session, I'll send you the information. I do have spots coming up in June. The other thing is, if you're wanting to learn how to do hypnosis sessions like I do, I highly recommend taking the Beyond Quantum Healing course. I'm going to put that link also in the description. It'll give you a little bit of a discount. Super sweet. We need as many people that can do this work as possible, because there's so much change that can happen in that work. If you're interested in learning energy healing, so you can go to the transfermotion.org website, go to the energy healing session, scroll down to levels of initiation, and in the level one section of Embodied Light, you'll be able to download the curriculum form. There's videos, there's a book that you can read along with it, and do the coursework that goes along with it. There's an energy attunement, energy activation. We go through universal law. It's a really great course, and it's totally here for you by donation. So send a donation to my PayPal. Listen, you know, do the coursework material. Open up those healing hands and spread the light as much as you can. Those of you who want to donate to support my work, I so appreciate it. It really helps me. You know, most of what I'm doing here at the Lighthouse is a service to this community. And most of my income and most of the support to keep the Lighthouse going really right now is coming through me doing these sessions, me doing mentorship with people, and the donations that you all are sending. So I want to thank you, because so many people from around the world have donated, you know, a little bit here or a big chunk there, and it has really added up. And I just want to send my love and gratitude out to you, because there's so many people, you know, that have walked into this space and have received information that was extremely valuable for them, very transformative, very healing. And there are people in this valley that have never even walked into this building that are receiving healing because you've shared your donations. I'm so thankful. I couldn't be more thankful. I love you all so much, and I can't wait to be with you. So I'm sending you love. I'm going to put the GoFundMe link so you can support the Lighthouse. Or you can also just send a donation via the PayPal thing. And I'm just like so blessed by all of you. So I love you. Have so much fun this weekend. Let your spiritual freak flag fly and celebrate. Love you. Bye-bye. For real.